अस्मिन् सुजति अवति अति न सज्जते अस्मिन् सुजति अवति अति न सज्जते अस्मिन् भूतेषु च अन्तर्हितः आत्मतन्त्रः भूतेषु चान्तर्हित आत्मतन्त्रः भूतेषु चान्तर्हित आत्मतन्त्रः षड्वर्गिकं जिगृति सद्गुण ईशः षड्वर्गिकं जिगृति सद्गुणेशः षड्वर्गिकं जिगृति सद्गुणेशः सवाइदं विश्वम् अमोघलीलः सृजति अवति अति न सज्जते अस्मिन् भूतेषु चान्तर्हित आत्मतन्त्रः षड्वर्गिकं जिग्रति सद्गुणेषु षड्गुणेशः सवाइदं विश्वममोघलीलः सृजति अवति अति न सज्जते अस्मिन् भूतेषु चान्तर्हित आत्मतन्त्रः षड्वार्गिकं जिग्रति सद्गुणेशः सह द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड वा अल्टरनेटिवली इदम दिस विश्वम मैनिफेस्टेड यूनिवर्सेस अमोघलीलः वन हूज एक्टिविटीज आर स्पॉटलेस सृजति क्रिएट्स अवति अति मेंटेन्स एंड एनिहिलेट्स ना नॉट सज्जते इज अफेक्टेड बाय अस्मिन् इन देम भूतेषु इन ऑल लिविंग बीइंग्स च आल्सो अंतर्हितः लिविंग विथिन आत्मतंत्रः सेल्फ इंडिपेंडेंट षड्वर्गिकं एंडोर्ड विथ ऑल द पोटेंसीज ऑफ हिज ऑपुलेंसेस जिग्रति सुपरफिशियली अटैच्ड लाइक स्मेलिंग द फ्रैग्रेंस सद्गुण ईशः मास्टर ऑफ द सिक्स सेंसेस ट्रांसलेशन एंड पर्पोर्ट बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद द लॉर्ड हूज एक्टिविटीज आर ऑलवेज स्पॉटलेस इज द मास्टर ऑफ सिक्स सेंसेस एंड इज फुल्ली ऑम्निपोटेंट विद सिक्स अपलेंसेस ही क्रिएट्स द मैनिफेस्टेड यूनिवर्सेस मेंटेन्स देम एंड एनिहिलेट्स देम विदाउट बीइंग इन द लीस्ट अफेक्टेड ही इज विद इन एवरी लिविंग बीइंग एंड इज ऑलवेज इंडिपेंडेंट. Please repeat the translation. The Lord, whose activities are always spotless, is the master of the six senses and is fully omnipotent with six appellances. He created the manifested universes, maintains them and annihilates them without being in the least affected. He is within every living being and is always independent. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. The prime difference between the Lord and the living entities is that the Lord is the creator and the living entities are the created. Here, he is called the Amogha Lilaha, which indicates that there is nothing lamentable in his creation. Those who create disturbances in his creation are themselves disturbed. He is transcendental to all material afflictions because he is full with all six appellances, namely wealth, power, fame, beauty, knowledge, and renunciation. And thus he is the master of the senses. He creates these manifested universes in order to reclaim the living beings who are within them suffering threefold miseries, maintains them, and in due course annihilates them without being least affected by such actions. He is connected with this material creation very superficially, as one smells odor without being connected with the odorous article. Non-godly elements therefore can never approach him despite all endeavors. Tasansa Bhaktivedanta Purport. Om Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuram Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namavom Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Srivasadi Gaura Bhaktarunda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So here Suta Goswami is narrating the sequence of items about the personality of Godhead and his interactions with the living entities, why he performs various pastimes, how to understand his capacities. So here he is saying, Sava idam Vishwam Amogha Lilaha. So in this Vishwam, material universe, Lord is performing superficial pastimes. Amogha means pure, spotless, where you cannot find out any fault in that pastimes. He may be doing materially perceivable wrong things for us, but they are all wonderful pastimes. They are without spotless, without any material tinges. No faults can be found in that pastimes. That's why it is mentioned as Amogha Lilaha. And what are that main pastimes? Srujati, Avati, Atti. He creates Srujati, Avati, he maintains Atti, he annihilates the entire universes, this Vishwam, because it is connected with the Vishwam. The main pastime is he is creating, maintaining them and annihilating them. So if he is creating, maintaining and annihilating them, is he affected? Because if you lose something which is very dear to you, your own vastu, you may feel get affected. But you see, nasajjate asman, without getting affected, he is doing all these pastimes. So, and it is also said, the capacity of the Lord, what is his capacity of the Lord? Shadvargikam and Sadguna Ishaha. He is the master of the six senses and he is omnipotent with six opulences. That is his natural propensity. He is the master of all the six opulences. Shadvargikam, Shadguneshaha, and also he is Bhuteshu Cha Antarhitaha. He is situated within all living entities as Paramatma, Super Soul. Atma Tantraha, and he is self-independent. He is always independent. So in this way, Lord is performing specific pastimes by which he is maintaining this universe also. He is not getting affected by these activities of the universe also. And his pastimes are such a way that they will liberate us from the cycle of birth. Why is he enacting all these pastimes? To liberate the living entities from this cycle of birth and death. So he created these manifested universes in order to reclaim the living beings who are within them suffering threefold miseries. He maintains them and in due course annihilates them without being least affected by such actions. So his specific purpose of performing all these pastimes was to reclaim the fallen souls, to give an opportunity to understand about the Lord, to get attachment towards the Lord, and to develop devotional service to the Lord, and finally go back home, back to Godhead. So in Bhagavatam, when I was trying to understand See, we all know about this creation, maintenance and annihilation. The technical details are all involved in two different parts of the Bhagavatam, second canto and third canto. Elaborate descriptions were there, how the Lord creates this material universe, technically each element, how it is created. So, as common people, how do we understand this? So, there is a narration in first canto when Lord was leaving Hastinapura and going towards Dwaraka. The ladies of Hastinapura, when they saw Krishna was traveling on the road, so when they saw Krishna, they went to the rooftops to have darshan of the Lord. When all the assembled ladies, when they saw the Lord there, then they started glorifying or offering prayers to the Lord. And their prayers were full of realization about the Lord and His activities. There are five verses which describe about the entire their understanding about the Lord. They says, Savai kilayam purusha puratano yadeka asid avishesha atmani agre gunebhyo jagadatman ishware nimilitatman nishi supta shaktishu. They are saying, Sayam purushaha puratanaha kilava. He is that original personality of Godhead. Puratana purushaha. That original personality, yad eka asid, and he is that one person, he is not multifarious. He has many capacities, but he is finally that one person, yad eka asid, agre avishesh gunebhyaha, before the manifested material creation, agre means before, avishesha, after the end also, before the creation and after the annihilation, he is that one personality who existed. Gunebhyaha, beyond the gunas. And in Atmani, Jagad Atmanishware, he is that one personality who is there as Paramatma in all living entities. And he is maintaining them, all living entities. Atmani, Jagad Atmani, Atmani Ishware, and Nimilit Atmanam, when all the living entities annihilate, they again merge into him. He is the one who is creating, maintaining, annihilating like that purpose. Nishishupta shaktishu, as if sleeping at night, then energy is suspended. So what happens when living entities, when the annihilation happens? Where do all the living entities go? Where do all the material elements go? So what is happening is, once the Lord has created one set of elements, so it is that the energy, like what is that Newton's law? Energy is neither created nor annihilated, it is transformed. That is what a transformation is happening. So once the Lord has first created this material universe, so it is in the elemental level, it is there. Then it is manifested as a proper universe where all the activities of the living entities are taken care. At the end, when it is annihilated, again it goes to the elemental level. And along with all the living entities, all these elements, they take shelter in the body of Mahavishnu. Or sometimes depends upon, at the night of Brahma, they all take shelter in Garbhodaksha Vishnu. So, Lord is a shelter for all these things. It is just created one time, but it is transformation happens going on. That's what all this is explained in Bhagavad Gita. Regularly, this material world is created and annihilated at certain intervals. And Lord had created a standard proforma, like once you make a system, the process is set. The process will take care. And process is handed out to material nature. And this material nature is also not working independently. She is like a shadow. That Brahma Samhita prayer, what we offer to Durga. Shrushti stuti pralaya sadhana shakti reka chayeva yasya bhuvanani bibarti Durga. Shrushti stuti pralaya sadhana. She is the sadhana. She can independently create Shrushti, maintain stiti, and pralaya. She can annihilate. But Chayeva. Chaya means shadow. So when we move only, our shadow will move. So without the sanction of the Lord, she does not act independently. She is just a shadow. Chayeva yasya bhuvanani bibarti durgaha. The Durga, she is much capable. She can independently act, but she acts just as the shadow of the Lord. So in that way, the Lord is empowered living entities, but He has also given a draft, how to work in that line. So that living entities are also given a guidance how to be in this world. And next he says, Sayeva Bhuyo Nijavirya Choditam Svajiva Mayam Prakritim Sishikshatim Anama Rupatmani Rupa Namani Viditsmamano Anusasara Shastrakrit. So when Lord had created this material world, He gives a chance for all living entities. One, to fulfill their desires. Second, to reform their understanding. Why is He creating this material world? Because the Jivas had the dormant tendencies. They want to be the Lord of everything. They want to exhibit their desires and capacities. So first purpose is to fulfill their desires. Next purpose is to reform them. Saying that whatever you are endeavoring, that is wrong. Your purpose to be serve the Lord. So reform your understanding. For these two purposes, Shastrakrut, the personality of Godhead, Sayeva Bhuyo Viditasmano, again desiring for their welfare, Anama Rupani Rupa Namani, although they are without name and form, He allocated name and form for the living entities. Can you identify a Jiva? Like we say, if there is a dog, there is an elephant, there is a mosquito, we identify with its form, with some name, in this life. But if you go to some other life, everything will change. He is not that person, he is not that name, he is not that form. So we are anama, anama, rupa. We are without name and form in this material world. But He has temporarily given us rupa atmani, rupa namani. He has given us one form, He has given us some name. Temporarily we identify for us with these things. Svajiva mayam, to whom did He give? To all His living parts and parts, to His living entities, parts and parcels. Anusashara, who are placed under the guidance, anushashana, under His guidance. Again He has given them, but under control, anushashana. Nijavirya choditam, by His own potency, prakritim sishakshatam, they are put under the control of material nature. So they have been given guidelines, but they are being under the monitor. Like whenever a teacher is there in the class, she will take care. But when she is going out, she will put the class leader, take care of the class. Nobody does any disturbance. And when the teacher comes back, if there is any disturbance, the class leader will update the teacher. This so and so are doing disturbance here. They will all be punished by the teacher. The same setup, with no difference. And next he says, Savayam yad padam atra surayo jitendriya nirjita matarishvanaha pashyanti bhakti utkalita atma amlata atmana nanu yesha sattvam parimarshatam arhati. So Lord is saying, Savayam yad padam atra. Here is the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, Supreme Lord. Surayo pashyanti, whom the great devotees had endeavored to have His darshan. Is Lord being visible to everyone and anyone? Only to very great personalities, when they do so much tapasya, they can perceive the Lord. And who are these people? Amala Atmanaha, who are completely purified personalities. Not everybody will get an opportunity to have darshan of the Lord. Only Amala Atmanaha, only pure personalities can have darshan. How? Bhakti Utkalita, when they are fully endowed with pure devotional service. Bhakti Utkalita and Nirjita Matarishvanaha, who have controlled their full sense control, who have regulated their life, senses and everything. And Jitendriyaha, who have controlled their senses. So mind has to be controlled, senses have to be controlled, they should be engaged in pure devotional service and they should do so much tapasya, only then they are purified. Then Jiva can have opportunity to have darshan of the Lord. See, so many restrictions are there. Not that easily anyone and everyone can have darshan. Nanu yesha arhati sattvam parimarshitam. This is the only way to become purified in this world. And there is no other way. These are the ladies of Hastinapura. They are talking this philosophy. Means they could understand the technical details, the essence of all the Vedic literature, they could understand. People were equipped with this kind of knowledge earlier times. And further they say, Krishna, specifically about Krishna, they say, Sava ayam shakti anugita satkato vedeshu guhyeshu cha guhya vadibihi yadeka isho jagadatma lilaya srujati avati yatti natatra sajjate. They are saying this Krishna's form is the most confidential form. Of all the incarnations, Krishna is the most confidential personality. They are saying, O Sakhi, my dear friends, Sava Isha Ayam, he is that same personality. Anugita Satkataha, whose attractive and confidential pastimes are described. Where? Vedeshu Guhyeshu Cha Guhya Vadibihi. By the devotees, the sages who have done endeavor to understand the Vedic literatures, they studied these Vedic literatures and they have described the pastimes of the Lord, which are confidentially placed around in all Vedic literatures. Ya eka atma lilaya, he is only one. Srujati avati atti jagat, who creates, maintains and annihilates this universe. Natatra sajjate, and he is not affected by any of his activities. The same verse, what we see is again they have concluded in that part there. So then if you are saying he is so confidential personality, why is he there among us? Why did he come to this material world? So then further they conclude by saying, Yadahi adharmena tamo diya nrupa. When there is adharma prominence, among whom? Nrupaha, the kings. Because of tamo diya, because of their contaminated intelligence, when they became tamasic in nature. When their intelligence is overcome by tamasic, when the kings, jivanti tatra isha hi satvatah kila. Because the Lord, who is transcendental form, datte bagam satvam rutam dayam yashaha bhavaya rupani dadad yuge yuge. He accepts various forms. Bhavaya rupani, he accepts various forms. Yuge yuge, in every yuga. For what purpose? Whenever the kings and administrators live like animals in the lowest mode of existence, the Lord in his transcendental form manifests his supreme power, the truth positive, shows special mercy to the faithful, performs wonderful activities and manifests various transcendental forms as is necessary in different periods and ages. So according to time, place, circumstances, what is required, Lord keeps performing these pastimes. So in one of our acharyas, Raghunath Das Goswami. So he used to sit at Radhakund and he used to meditate upon the pastimes of the Lord, the confidential pastimes of Radha and Krishna. One such pastime, what he had narrated in the form of a book, was known as Mukta Charita. Mukta Charita means a pearl pastime. We have seen in that Little Krishna video, the pearl pastime. How many of you know this story, pearl pastime? So one day during Kartik month, because Diwali is the festival that time, so Govardhan Puja, the most opulent way people will be celebrating there. So all the people of Vrindavana were making arrangements to look gorgeous, to make best of the garlands, best of the necklaces and everything and all. So Radharani with all her friends had assembled so many pearls. And they are making garlands for themselves. They are making different varieties, designs to decorate themselves. And everyone, they were talking around, I'll be looking good, I'll be looking stunning, I'll be looking gorgeous, like that. All the women were, all the gopis and sakis, they were all making discussions and all. So Krishna got to know through his friends. His friend is one parrot. So which flew to the Radharani's area and saw what they are all doing. It came back and explained to Krishna that they are all making very nice garlands made of pearls. So when Krishna heard this, then Krishna wanted some of the pearl garlands to decorate his beautiful calves, Hamsi and Harini. These are the two beautiful calves of Krishna. So he went to the gopis there and requested, please give two pearls at least, two pearl garlands to decorate my calves. Then Radharani and they are all talking, pearls are meant for human beings, not meant for animals. They started making fun, criticizing, the making jokes about Krishna and the past, with his cows and calves, all these things and all. Then they were laughing and making fun. Krishna was begging them literally, please at least give two. They were saying no. Then Lalita, she went to her bag and found one half pearl broken. She said, this is what maximum we can give to you. We cannot give anything beyond this. So Krishna became very much offended. Now he thought, let me teach all of these people a lesson. So he went home and requested Mother Yashoda, please give me some pearls. I will plant them and I will make trees grow out of pearls. Then Mother Yashoda started laughing. What is that, Krishna? What you are saying? Pearls are not grown to trees. They come from oceans. Krishna said, no, 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 I have seen my father. He is sowing seeds and he is bringing fruits out. So I will also do the same process. I will follow my footsteps of my father. You give me. Then not to dissatisfy Krishna, and she gave some pearls from her store. So Krishna took that pearls. He went to the river Yamuna. He made a small plot where he could plow. He cleaned the area, made sectors, and you know how to, before plowing a seed, you have to do all the physical process there. He did everything. Then he plowed all the pearls there. Then he said, how to water them? You have to get the best pearls, like moon, shining, glittery, milky moon. He said, we have to require milk as watering them. So he sent Madhumangala to the gopis, requesting them, give some milk. Because they every day you transport milk and cow products to for selling, gopikas. So he requested them to give some milk. When Madhumangala went, they started making fun of him. Then they started criticizing him. They said, they cannot give anything. And simply you are wasting your time, and you are, they started all making fun of Krishna and his activities of growing pearls and all these things and that. Then Krishna went back to his mother and requested, give me milk so that I will be able to water my plants. Mother Yashoda gave whatever is required. Then he started making, bringing milk every day, morning and evening, making watering them with milk, all these things and all. Slowly small, small sprouts started coming after a few days. Then the small trees, they started growing. Then Krishna called all the gopis and wanted to show, see, you all criticize me that I cannot do anything. See, now see what is coming up. Then they all came, then they started laughing and they're saying, this is not the pearl trees, they're all thorn trees which have come here. You are wasting your time by wasting all the milk and milk products to this field. And have you ever heard that pearls will come with trees like that? And all, they started making fun. But slowly, slowly, in a few days, that trees became so big, then they started flowering, and that flowering, that so much smell was coming, the entire Vrindavan got filled with like a nectarian smell. Then all people came there to see what is happening there. Then for the trees, there were beautiful pearls of different colors and so huge size which one has never experienced in this world. Because Lord is all potent, he can create whatever he wants. And all the gopis, they are seeing that pearls and seeing this small flower to Krishna's pearl. See, their pearl is this size and Krishna's pearl is this size, like that. And they were all thinking, we will become the laughing stock. Krishna will decorate cows with all these pearls and we will be decorated with all that a moon and a glow worm. See, when there is no moon, the glow worm will be very dark, very light. In front of moon, glow worm is of no use. So like that, they all started feeling, then they all started doing meetings. Now we should pacify Krishna, we should get the best of the pearls from him. Then they sent one of their assistants to barter with Krishna. See, what you want? We'll give you gold, milk, curds, dahi, sweets, all these things and all. You give us some pearls. What happened? No, sorry. In the meantime, what happened? Now gopis thought, okay, now Krishna is growing, so we can also grow. So they also went home. They took all their pearls. They requested their mothers also to give all their pearls in the house. So they went to a area. Then they started digging because they had so much milk, curds, ghee, butter. They also started using all these things and all. So they plowed all these things over a small few days. Then sprouts came. Then after some time they saw that what is all not what they had commented. Thorny bushes. The thorny bushes came to them. So in that way they tried everything, but all their pearls are lost, all their endeavor is lost, and they became a laughing stock. Now they thought, now before the festival we can't be like that. Now everything we lost, now we have to take something from Krishna. They so sent some people to barter. Then Krishna said, no, I am not going to give anything. You gave me broken piece, I am not going to give even that broken piece to you. So then again, each individual gopi started coming and she saying, this is what I have, please give me something. Krishna was not even accepting any of their offers. And Radharani was not coming forward. She is sending all her friends to manage with Krishna and she is aside, hearing what Krishna is saying. So they all got disappointed and they went away to Radhakund. They were all sitting silently and in a morose mood, all these things and all. Then Krishna started making best of the garlands with all the best of the pearls available. According to the personality, he started making different designs. And he started making boxes with their specific name. And he started engraving them. He started filling them with all the gifts. And he started sending them to all the gopis individually by his friends as gifts to all of them. See, in that way, Krishna had managed this pastime and he had performed this pastime. So many other discussions were there. It's a big book. We are just understanding the story in essence. So Krishna, because he is Amogha Leelaha, he can perform anything and everything because he is all capable personality. There is one more story connected with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this time. So we all know in Chaitanya Charitamrita there is a pastime happened with Danda Bhanga, where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's rod was broken. That is on the way entrance to Puri. Just before entrance to Puri, there is one river, Bhargavi, where this Danda Bhanga pastime happened. So that is the place where it is all called, this area is called as Dandakaranya. Dandakaranya, this is the place where, that place it is said that there is a reference to Guhaka. You know Guhaka? Who was that boatman who had helped Ramachandra and Sita Devi cross the river. And it was his province there. There was earlier a deity of Guhaka in that area with tears continuously coming out of his eyes. So when Ramachandra had asked him, why are you crying incessantly? Why your tears are not stopping even after having my darshan? Why are you crying? So Guhaka said, see, Srimati Sita Devi, she is the mother of the universe. She is supposed to stay in the best of the places in the palaces and sleep on the best of the places. Now see, she is sleeping on the hard rock stones and living the life of most difficult situation. By seeing her situation, that's why I am crying incessantly. So that deity was there with continuous tears coming out of that area. So when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this pastime performed of Dandamanga, so later Pratap Rudra, who was the king of that area, came to that place to commemorate the pastime performed there, and he had established one deity known as Dandabhanga Gopinatha. That is the deity what was established there. And the speciality of this deity is he performs pastimes even now, that Krishna deity. So there was one pujari who was a great devotee of the Lord, who was taking care of the deity. So every day he used to go offer to the deity, decorate him, take care of him very nicely. There was a devotional rapport between the deity and that pujari. So nicely he was able to take care. But Krishna was very much attracted to playing. You know, Krishna is, he wants to play. So whenever pujari finishes his offering and goes away, Krishna, as a form of deity, comes out like a boy and he starts playing around with all the boys there. He is very much interested in playing one game called Gucci Tandu. It is something like a local cricket, like in Odia it is Gucci Tandu. What does that mean? Not heard of it. Mostly it is like a local cricket, they say, or like Karrabilla. Something like that, you have to play, you have to catch. It's like local cricket. So Krishna was very much interested. Every day, as soon as the pujari goes, he runs away to play this game with all the local boys. So one day, pujari, when he came back a little early, and he saw, when he opened the altar, deity is not there. No, what to do, where to find him? Then he went there, he saw some boys are playing around in the near vicinity. Then when he saw there, that Gopinatha is playing with all the boys there, out of anger, he said, what, you are supposed to be in the altar. Why are you playing here? He took one stick there to beat Gopinatha, to chase him away. So as soon as Gopinatha saw that pujari is running to catch him, he ran away from that place as fast as possible. When he came near the temple, he jumped onto the altar and became the deity there. So in that way, he used to perform this pranaya pastimes with the devotees. He used to enjoy, he used to play around, he used to go around. So like that, many stories are there. One day, one rich man wanted to offer a flute to the Lord. So he had made a best flute with silver, gold and special jewels all these things predicted on the flute, and he had come and he had offered to the deity, and that speciality of the flute got famous everywhere, and people started coming to have darshan of that flute, that is so great flute, all these things and all. So in that people, there is one thief who got to know that this flute has been offered. So he thought, mera jindagi ban jayega, just steal away this flute and my life will be successful. So one day he had planned, he had studied the entire thing. So when what time pujari will go away, what time the temple will be locked, what time next day morning he will come. So he had studied overnight, he stayed in that area. When pujari had left, he went there, opened, broke the temple door and went inside, picked up that flute, and when he came out, he saw there was a huge snake outside. That huge snake was with that had unlimited hoods, and so huge snake, he was almost like fear to death. So there was a huge tree, he climbed up the tree and he was hugging to the tree, and whole night he was shivering. And the snake was guarding, if he comes down, I'll bite him, how you can take away the flute? Then the next day morning, when the pujari came for Mangalarti to open, he saw there was a huge snake on the road. Then he saw it is seeing somebody on the tree. Then he saw somebody on the tree, there he saw the thief who was sitting on the tree, shivering and fearful for his life. When he saw down, again snake vanished. So that is a symptom that Adishesha is continuously guarding the temple, and if there anybody comes there, he is ready to finish him off. So again, that thief was caught and the flute was given back and back to the deity, and like this, these pastimes were all being performed. Even with the deity, when Lord is able to perform, what to say when he is physically present, what and all he cannot perform. That's why he is mentioned here as Amogha Leelaha. Like this, we hear many of these pastimes in and around Vrindavan. You go to Banki Bihari temple, you see so many pastimes being Lord performing there in Vrindavana, because it is called Nitya Leela Sthala. The Lord is eternally present there. Not that he finished his pastimes 5000 years away and went back. That these dhamas are called as Nitya Leela Sthalas. Lord is eternally present in these dhamas and he is performing his pastimes eternally there. Like there was one situation a few years back. How many few years back, we don't know. This is a local story again. So there was a heavy rainfall in Vrindavan area. See, Vrindavan is famous for everything heavy. Sunshine will be heavy, summer will be very heavy, winter will be very heavy, or anything will be excess only there. So one day there was a heavy rainfall in that Govardhan area, that it became very difficult for people to stay. Water was logging everywhere. And not only water, the problem is with the living entities of like cows, goats, monkeys, all these things and all. So they will not get any shelter. So there was one Baba who was taking care of the situation. Then he saw all the living, all the cows, they were all having difficult. 5000 years ago, when a big calamity came, Krishna had protected all of them by giving shelter under the Govardhan hill. Now what to do when Krishna, now how to protect all these living entities, specifically cows and calves, all these things and all. Then he accumulated few people there who could do manage something. So they performed they accumulated whatever possible material was there. They made a hut, something like that, a shelter for all these cows who could take from this rain. He did possible all these things and all. For next 48 hours he was working. And because of so much working, he forgot to eat in this entire 48 hours. So next day, after finishing all this work and when he went to sleep in the night, at the dead of the night he woke up because he was feeling so hungry that he was unable to sleep because of hunger. Because he has been working for last 48 hours. Then when he opened his eyes, suddenly he got up and he sat. Then he suddenly, there was a knock on the door. There was one small boy who came there. He said, you have worked so hard to take care of the cows, take this prasadam of the laddus. And he also left one stick, because you are taking care of the cows, you require one cow stick to take care, to herding the cows. So he left these two things and vanished away. So he ate that laddus and slept away. Next day morning, there was an entire halla-gulla in the village. The deity, the Srinathji deity, who was there on the top of Govardhana. So his golden plate and the cow herding stick were vanished. So all the pujaris, then they started informing, they started maybe thinking some thief had come to steal away all these things and all. So in the meantime, he got to know that some things were missing from the temple. So he immediately went home and saw, this is the same plate and this is the same stick. So he doesn't want to become famous, so this devotee went to the pujari's house and handed over to him. He said, yesterday night, one cowherd boy came to my house and handed over them to me. And he kept at my house and went away. So I told, no. So is this your the temple ones? Then that pujari took back and he said, yes, these are our temple ones. He put back to the deity. So the Lord is ready to serve the devotees. Because you are serving the other creatures which are very dear to the Lord. Lord is ready to serve. Like this, many pastimes are there. You go around in Vrindavana. You keep hearing all these pastimes regularly happening. So this is the capacity. That's why he is known as Amogha Leelaha. He performs unlimited pastimes within this material world, with these material elements. He is giving opportunity so that we all get attracted to him, fascinated by him. By become fascination, we become attracted to him. By become attracting, by we develop a relation with him. When we develop a relationship with him, we become more stronger in our devotional service. So slowly, this is the perspective required for us. The more we hear, the more we understand, the more we connect, we should build our relationship with the Lord and make our life successful. So for that, acharyas have given us great opportunity, like Prabhupada has given us the wonderful details in Bhagavatam. The technical details like Vedeshu, Guhyeshu, that confidential Vedic subjects which are very difficult for common personalities have been given to us for access through purports. The technical revelation Prabhupada is revealing to us so that we could understand the glory of the Lord and develop attraction and attachment for him and slowly develop that attitude of going back home, back to Godhead. And we should endeavor for this purpose. So this entire, this first few details, next few verses are also making us come to the point to coming attachment to Bhagavatam. There are five verses in the further which glorifies the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam, importance of Srimad Bhagavatam, the technical aspects of Srimad Bhagavatam. This is such a great literature. Amala Puranam, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says. Srimad Bhagavatam Puranam Amalam, Yad Vaishnavanam Priyam. This is the most spotless book, Purana. Narrations of the pastimes of the Lord. Srimad Bhagavatam Puranam Amalam, for whom it is Vaishnavanam Priyam. It is most dear to the Vaishnavas. Yad Paramahamsa Samhitam. And this book is meant for that Paramahamsas. So like that, we have this opportunity to read, understand the Srimad Bhagavatam and develop that, revive our devotional service to the Lord and go back home, back to Godhead. And the Srimad Bhagavatam is also the personification of Lord Krishna. In Padma Purana, there is a description which says the entire Srimad Bhagavatam, 12 cantos are the different bodily parts of the Lord. So in that way, by reading all these cantos slowly, 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 we'll be developing that attraction to the Lord. And finally, we have been blessed by this Bhagavatam, by Prabhupada, in a language where we can understand. If Sanskrit would have been, it will be impossible for us to understand. But Prabhupada's first endeavor to be merciful to the people is, he translated Bhagavatam. So we'll see more such related information in the further verses. I'll stop here. Any questions or doubts?
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Prabhu, from the purport, we started with the purport saying that Lord is a creator and the living entities are created. What it means, is it something the bodily material manifestation you're talking, or is it the spiritual level you're saying, Prabhu? Because from Gita we understand we are eternal as a living entity. So can you please elaborate on that part, Prabhu?
See, it was that Lord who had created all the living entities in the first phase. One time creation happens, not that regularly it keeps happening. And there are various different descriptions about this, reference about that Lord is one personality, but for his enjoyment he had created all the living entities. These quotes Prabhupada had put various places in purports and all. So then again, we are all emanations from the Lord, like his energies. Different categories of energies are there: internal potency, marginal potency, and external potency. We are all potencies which are emanated from the body of the Lord. For his desire, for his satisfaction, for his pleasure. All these three levels of potencies have been created. So being the marginal potency, when we come to this material world, we have to be given what is required facilities. Like you join a company, if you have work has to be done through you, facilities have to be provided to you. Like a laptop, a desk space, a sitting area, some, all these basic amenities are required. So like that, for living entities, some amenities are required. Lord is giving them according to their desires, to fulfill their requirements, he is providing them the necessary body, the necessary capacity, according to his karma, kala, many things have been provided by the Lord. So in that way it says, spiritually Lord had created and materially he is creating various bodies also. In both ways we can understand. Unless we are created by the Lord, where is our existence? But this is mostly talking about material nature. In that verse, whatever he is talking about, this is talking about that Vishwam, material universe, where he created, maintained and annihilated. But he is saying, but you are aloof from this concept, but you are my eternal part and parcels. In 15th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, 15.7, what is the verse? Mamai vamsho jivaloke jivabhuta sanatanaha. He is saying, my amshaha, you are my part. Mamai vamsha jivaloke, all the living entities in this material world. Mamai vamsho jivaloke jivabhuta sanatanaha. And these jivabhutas are sanatana, they are eternal in nature. ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की श्रील प्रभुपाद की निताय गौर प्रेमानंद।